I'm going to talk to you about energy and transportation. So I need you to bear with me. I'm going to go on a little bit of a narrative arc. Hopefully, I'm going to bring it to a point. So let's start. 20 years I've been working in fuel cells and hydrogen. I'll get to that in a minute. But in those 20 years, what have we seen? Finally, renewables are scaling. Yeah, scale, proper, serious scale. You've heard from some of the guys here. But there's an increasing understanding of what engineers have known for a long time, which is the sun doesn't shine all the time. Yeah? The markets are starting to understand the need for storage, yeah, and the frustration with putting really amazing batteries in car parks. We've also finally realized that electric cars are really awesome. Finally, why did it take so long? Yeah, I was talking to somebody only 3 years ago. When he was doing an investment round, they were like, don't mention those electric cars. People will think you're crazy. Yeah? And now they're like, don't mention those combustion things. People will think you're crazy. Yeah? So electric cars are awesome, but it's not quite perfect yet. Because the grid's got capacity limits. I think we've all started to understand. We also have another challenge, which batteries have a range and a payload limit. This is not range anxiety. This is not people overcoming the newness of a technology. This is the fundamental limits of physics. So we keep burning. There are a whole range of transport applications where we're just going to keep burning stuff for quite a while. We all know the problems with that, because dirty air is killing people. So this isn't Beijing. This is London. I could show you a similar picture of Paris, New York, Los Angeles. Take your pick. So we've made this incredible progress, but we haven't made enough progress. So the question is, what do you do? So the first answer is everything. Yeah? All the good stuff. Invest in everybody. Yeah? But I'm going to talk to you about one specific thing, which is hydrogen and fuel cells. So you may have heard about it for a long time. The key thing of hydrogen is you can do storage, so grid, and you can do mobility. And so there's not only me that thinks this, the Hydrogen Council, there's a whole group of massive global corporates across the world growing very quickly to make this happen. You may also have heard some people saying, batteries also do that. Are batteries good or are fuel cells good? So just very quickly, they're both good. Yeah? On the left is a battery and on the right is a fuel cell. Yeah, to those of you who are familiar, you're like, they're more or less the same. I showed this to somebody, you're like, no, they're not. Electrochemically, they're sister technologies. These are siblings. They would need to work together. So now, finally, I get to the point. Arcola Energy. So we are enabling zero-emission mobility for cities, regions, and countries using hydrogen fuel cells and batteries. Yeah, we're a small company, UK SME, founded in 2010, growing ever since. Strong links into the science base, so pulling through science. Very strong links into the global hydrogen fuel cell supply chain. We've got a reputation, despite our small size, for actually getting things done. We have got traction in the market, and we're ready to scale. So just very quickly, how do we work? The first, on the left then, the small text, is we actually find markets where it makes sense. There are a lot of things you can do with a fuel cell that make no sense. We don't do that. The second thing we do is we build industrial partnerships. I like exclusive partnerships by territory and by application, where we can make things happen and work together. That's the picture on the right. I want to explain it. Understand what the market is, understand what people want, find the right technology, put it into place. So what we provide, the bit that we can protect, the software, the control, the proprietary IP, we also then will supply the equipment and all of the engineering needed, and critically the route to market, how to actually apply this in a place where it makes sense, not on another unicorn project that doesn't go anywhere. What does it look like? A double-deck bus. Sometimes you can believe what's written on the side of a bus. Yeah? So. I wasn't actually planning to say that. I hope that wasn't too political. So on the side of this double-deck bus, it could say 200 plus miles of zero-emission range. Not just turn off while you go down Oxford Street and poison all the other people. 200 miles zero emissions. No loss of passengers. Yeah? And the reason we can do that is if you put batteries and fuel cells together, you get 3 times the energy density. So don't fight them. Make them be friends. Yeah? And our particular bus, because we do rather good engineering, we get the best-in-class efficiency, so our double deck uses the same amount of hydrogen as a typical single deck. Yeah? So twice as many people, same amount of energy. So traction in the market. We've got a long-lasting relationship now that's moving forward really quickly with the largest double-deck bus manufacturer in the world, biggest bus company in the UK. We're just moving to trucks in 2019, just starting to build those relationships. We are in negotiations, hopefully I'll be able to tell you soon, on the new UK hydrogen train. And building collaboration now with the largest Scottish shipyard. So those are the markets, buses and trucks, trains and ships. Big stuff, where it actually makes a real impact. And I did a tiny bit of consulting for a Formula One team. just to depress me, really, about how much resource goes into a slightly pointless sport. They have so many toys. I'll stop, sorry. So in terms of the addressable market, there's about 500,000 buses expected by mid-2020s. There's about 5 million, 10 million trucks. It's an enormous market. If we can just do 10,000 vehicles, it's a $1 billion business. That'll do me fine for a week, and then we'll keep growing. So my question's very simple. At this stage, I'm not looking for investments, so I don't even have to be told not to ask you. But I really would like your help. So customers. I want to find who are the really amazing customers I should work with in every country of the world, in every sector. So buses and trucks, heavy vehicles particularly, shipping and trains later, but also around market creation. Like, these technologies are not that easy to bring in. Yeah? You can't just displace diesel easily. Diesel's really cheap, it just happens to be evil. Yeah? So help in cities and regions, people who want to make things happen. So please do come find me, I'd love to talk to you. Thank you.